Λοιπόν, έχουμε τον κύριο Ευγενίδη εδώ, ο οποίος είναι όρθιος και μας αναμένει να μας αναγγείλει μια φοβερή συνέντευξη που έκανε, η οποία...
Ο κύριος Νικόλας Χρυστάκης είναι Ελληνοαμερικανός, ίσως τον έχετε ακούσει σε αυτούς τους μήνες. Είναι καθηγητής κοινωνικών και φυσικών επιστημών στο Yale, ένας από τους ανθρώπους που και τον συμβουλευόταν ο Πρωθυπουργός στο πρώτο σκέλος της πανδημίας και είναι ένας από τους ανθρώπους που μελετούν τις επιδημίες με εξαιρετικά ενδιαφέρουσες προβλέψεις για την εξέλιξη αυτού του πράγματος. Κάναμε μια συζήτηση στο πλαίσιο της ελληνικής προεδρίας του Συμβουλίου της Ευρώπης που τη διοργάνωσε ο Μιλτιάδης ο Βαρβιτσιώτης, ο αναπληρωτής Υπουργός Εξωτερικών. Έχουμε ένα μεγάλο απόσπασμα αυτής της κουβέντας. Νομίζω ότι είναι εξαιρετικά ενδιαφέρουσες, όσο και δύσκολες οι προβλέψεις του για το πότε θα επανέλθουμε σε μια φυσιολογικότητα και πότε θα έρθει αυτή η ρημάδα η κανονικότητα. Κάνω ένα μικρό spoiler, δεν θα είναι γρήγορα.
Δεν θα είναι γρήγορα. Μας έκανε στην καρδιά περιβόλη. Για να ακούσουμε τον Ευγενίδη με το Χρυστάκι.
We meet at a time when Pfizer announced that it's only a matter of time to have a safe and effective vaccine against coronavirus. Is this a glimmer of hope, a sign for a return to normality in the coming weeks and months?
Yes, of course, it's good news. But you have to understand that scientists fully expected that we would have a successful vaccine or several vaccines discovered sometime in the near future. But it's not just a question of discovering a vaccine. We also have to manufacture and distribute it and persuade very large numbers of people, millions of people, to take the vaccine. And those steps will take additional time. So I suspect it'll be until 2022, some approximately, before we really begin to get some relief from this pandemic because of the vaccine.
Do you see a great hardship? Do you see obstacles in this effort to get people along, to convince people all across the globe to get the vaccine?
Yes, of course. This is a classic problem, is persuading people to use the vaccine. First of all, just to back up a moment, this particular vaccine, the Pfizer vaccine, requires a very cold chain. The cold chain is where when you distribute the vaccine has to be kept at very low temperature, I think below minus 80 in this case.
And so it's also a matter of facilities.
Yes, you need special trucks, special refrigerators, and the vaccine can never be hot. You know, it can never warm up to room temperature. So this is itself a very difficult challenge. But even if we surpass that challenge, then we have the challenge, as we're discussing, of persuading people to accept the vaccine. And here, this is why credibility on the part of political leaders is so important. Because if political leaders have been honest with people, have been honest about the risks, honest about the uncertainty, honest about their own ignorance, or honest about their optimism, all along the way, when the time comes to attempt to persuade people to take the vaccine, those figures will be seen as more credible and will be believed. So you see, effective leadership in a time of a pandemic, one of the pillars of effective leadership is transparent, frequent, and honest communication that doesn't sugarcoat things, you know, that says this is a difficult challenge. This is what we know, this is what we don't know, and so on.
This is very interesting, and you also touch upon a key element, a key parameter of democracies, which is trust. So where is this bottom line where there is a fragmentation in trust vis-a-vis not only leaderships, but also the scientific community? We see many people challenging scientific judgment, which should not be the case, honestly.
Well, scientists, of course, challenge each other. That's the nature of the scientific process. And this is why I said it's important to communicate uncertainty. So it is, science is, you see, self-correcting, right? So what is your evidence for a case? Oh, here's my evidence. Well, here's counter evidence. Now what do we do? You know, do we reject the original position? Do we revise the original position? This is the nature of science. And so this is why it's important for scientists, of course, to be humble and careful in what they say, and for political leaders to be careful as well. But for both parties, what's important is communicating the evidence for a claim. So if politicians come forward and say this vaccine works, they should also tell the public, and here's what we know, here's why we believe it works, here's the risks of the vaccine, and here's the uncertainty. And you see, this requires also maturity on the part of the public, right? Democracies, people get the governments they deserve, you know, they get the governments they vote for.
In your initial response, You made this prediction about the return to normality, which will take some more time. Do you think societies will get back to where they were? Will we ever return to the status quo ante?
Well, first of all, even when we have widespread adoption of a vaccine, it's still going to take time for us to recover, because just look at the economic devastation from this pandemic. Many businesses have gone out of business. Many people have lost their jobs. There's a lot of economic problems that have arisen and that will take time to unwind, and social problems as well, and psychological problems. And there'll be clinical problems too. Maybe 5% of people with COVID will have long-term disability. So there'll be millions of Europeans and Americans and Asians and Africans with disability as a result of these infections. And so all of these things will also continue to affect us. So I think it'll be about 2024 before we begin to return complete, more or less to normal. And this is also typical of past pandemics. So if you look at a previous serious epidemic disease around the world and across history, it takes a while for people to recover from the epidemiological shock and then the economic and social shock.